Right. Well, good evening, everyone. I think we're going to wait a few seconds here to make sure that everyone is on.
Text me all the questions.
Thank you, everyone. As people are slowly trickling in, we will get started. Really want to open up and thank Governor First Lady and Lieutenant Governor for joining us at the roundtable tonight in collaboration with CAAL. Usually we have these monthly roundtables to bridge the community, the API community, with the governor's office. And so given what has happened Tuesday night, we wanted to open this up and again appreciate the collaboration with CAAL and also those who are helping us stream live uptake and Bay Hmong TV. So wanted to give this opportunity for healing space for the community. And well, I will hand it off to Botel Obraff from CAAL to introduce our prayer here.
Thank you, Plua, for opening us up, and thank you, Governor Walz, First Lady, and I know that there are others who are joining us from the administration and across our state agencies, and so I really appreciate that. As was shared, my name is Botel Rabe, and I'm the Executive and Network Director here at the Coalition of Asian American Leaders. I am sorry that we are gathering today under these circumstances. I just want to share that during this first half hour, we will be spending time with the governor, the first lady, Lieutenant Governor, Commissioner Lucero, and other leaders who are joining us, because we believe it's important for our state leaders to hold our community's concerns and pain at this time. And that we will then transition to just an Asian Minnesotan space after, so that we can safely share our feelings and how we're doing at this moment. I know that if you are like me, that momentary shock when we heard about what happened in Atlanta is now turned into pain, and we're all feeling a lot of emotions at this time. So I want you to know that we see you. And we know that the energy that you have spent trying to justify that we as Asian Americans experience racism is not for naught. I know it is very difficult to understand at this point, but today I want to let you know that you can let that off your shoulders, because we want to be in community together and to talk about how you're doing. And so also we're joined by different healers, and so we are fortunate to have them in our space to continue to hold us and to also support us as we are all going through this. With that, I'm going to invite one of our community elders and healers to open us up. Dzongkai Mua is an elder that I have known for many, many decades, it seems. He is like a father figure and just someone that we respect greatly. And so I wanted him to be here so that he can give us some words and give us some blessings as we struggle through this moment together. So, Zongkai, ya te ka ba tao na ge sa ta ka hai a pe la lu cha pe shi ro sha tia to a sha da lu shi ha ni ni wa na.
Ole tao ke le. Hi, Governor and everyone. My name is Zongkai Mua, and it's now very pleased for me to be with your group tonight, but is unfortunately that something happened to our people, to our Asian people in Georgia, and it's hurt everyone in the United States, including all the people in Minnesota. And I'm here to say to the people of Georgia and all the Asian people in the United States, we have been through this tragedy many, many times, even from our own country and come to America. Our hope is to be happy, to be healthy, but somehow something that happened to us and to our people, including all the people from Asia, refugee or non-refugee that come to Asia. But Minnesota is our home, and we hope that with your help, with your encouragement, we will go through this, we will work through this tragedy. And with the help of everyone, I think I would like to have the idea for all the Asian people in Georgia, just come together like us here, come together, share the sorrow, share the tragedy together, and anything that they can help each other, come to each other, that will help to heal the wounded that we have in Georgia. And now I would like to say a couple words in Hmong in case that we have some Hmong people who live in Georgia or in St. Paul here. I would like to hear that what we do.
I would like to continue to say to the people of Minnesota, Georgia, and all the states in the United States, we would like to look at the big picture that all people who live in the United States, we are people that care and love one another. And we would like to look at to the world that we are leading to lead the people in other nations. So the people in the United States, we should come together and help one another. Even we care or something that we can donate it, or we can come to each other and help to heal this tragedy to our people in Georgia. And I like our people that come together like the governor here in Minnesota call us together. This is a good idea to help one another. And thank you so much for the time.
Okay, next we're gonna have our Governor Tim Walz share a few remarks.
Well, thank you, Bo, and thank you for the beautiful words of unity. And I want to thank the community, both here in Minnesota and in Georgia and across the country, for trusting me to share time in your space of pain and grief. The unspeakable attacks in Atlanta are not just an attack on the Asian community, they're an attack on all of us. The grief that this community is feeling here in Minnesota, we are flying our flags at half staff as a visual reminder. The Asian community, Pacific Islander community, the beautiful tapestry that makes Minnesota is what makes this such a great place to be. And the fear and discrimination and racism that you are feeling cannot stand. None of us can say it's enough to say that we're not racist. Now is the time for voices to be lifted up, for actions to be taken, and to make it clear that our brothers and sisters, no matter where their country of origin is, this is their home. This is their home. Many of you on this call have been in Minnesota far longer than my family, but it doesn't matter if you arrived yesterday or you arrived decades ago. You are part of this beautiful tapestry, and this is your place. And our hearts grieve for our brothers and sisters in Georgia. We stand in solidarity with you. We know that this tragic act, sadly, was not unpredictable. The rhetoric we hear from people, the folks that are willing to tolerate bullying of our children in schools, attacks on our families, it's where this leads to. It is all too predictable. And we are committed in Minnesota as a community to standing with you as we go through your pain and grief. And we need to stand there with you as we heal and come out stronger. We've said from the beginning, way before COVID, that this unity is what makes us strong. Our diversity is our strength. And we also said that this virus does not discriminate, and we certainly shouldn't. But we've known that because of language and because of the actions of some who believe it's acceptable, that these increased attacks are happening. And many of them go unreported. They're just the things that happen daily, whether it be in the workplace or at school, and they are unacceptable. And we in Minnesota, I would encourage all of us on here, these conversations are a place of healing, but we also need action. We need to strengthen our hate crime laws. You need to know that if you do this to a neighbor, that there are consequences for it, whether they be actions of discrimination, racism, or the horrible actions of violence aimed at our communities. So I can tell you this, as governor, I understand my responsibility to each and every one of you is to use this platform to condemn these acts, to condemn the discrimination and the racism, and to put things in place that tear down the systemic racism that you endure. Because again, so many of you have come here, you have continued to build this state, you have continued to invest in all of the activities, whether it be business, education, medicine, the arts, teaching. You are Minnesota, you are this country. So I can tell you, I'll turn it over to the First Lady and you'll hear from the Lieutenant Governor. But as the governor of the state of Minnesota, I can just clearly take to you is hate has no home in Minnesota and we will not tolerate it. We stand with you in unity. We stand with you in making the changes necessary, and none of us can feel and rest easy until every single one of us can feel and rest easy. First Lady.
Thank you. Good evening. And thank you so much for having me here tonight, for including me in this conversation. I think ideas of inclusiveness and encouragement are much underrated. Too many in our Asian American community have been so traumatized that you may be feeling desensitized even to these hate crimes. This attack is part of a pattern that follows a long history of anti-Asian racism and hate. And it is critically important, as the governor said, that these do not go unchallenged. Some may say their thoughts and prayers are with you, are with us, of course. But that is not a reason for no action. That is not an excuse to not challenge what has happened here. Tim and I hear your concerns. And we want you to know we stand in solidarity with you. My prayer goes out to all of our children, to all of our families, to all of our friends, to your children, to your family, to your friends who are grieving tonight, and to you.
Thank you, Governor Walz and First Lady Gwen Walz for joining us and giving us those words. And we look forward to continuing to work with you. I can't see the screen, so I don't know. Is Lieutenant Governor Peggy Flanagan here yet?
I'm here. So good afternoon, everyone. I'm really honored and humbled to be able to be with you. I'm coming to you right now from my kitchen, which is where you would all be if you were in my home. And while we can't gather together in person in this moment, and I know how difficult that is, I'm grateful to be at this table with you virtually, although I wish we were able to talk about something that wasn't so deeply painful for so many. I wanted to thank Mr. Kai for getting us started in a good way and keeping us grounded in who we are and where we come from as human beings and as people. As has been mentioned, these attacks that occurred this week are horrifying and traumatic. But unfortunately, I think are not surprising based on what we have heard for generations, but frankly, the rhetoric that has been ramped up over the last year in particular. And the attacks on Tuesday, we cannot separate them from frankly, the racism and misogyny that is deeply embedded with what happened and with much of this rhetoric, and we have to name it. You know, we live in a state where we have folks from all walks of life, and as the governor mentioned, this is your home, you are Minnesotan. And as an Indigenous person to this land, I know that you belong here and will be your ally and will be with you shoulder to shoulder in pushing back on this rhetoric. But as the governor, you know, mentioned, there are people who in Minnesota who think that we can Minnesota nice our way through moments like these, or simply say to talk about issues like white supremacy makes people too uncomfortable. Well, the discomfort that we feel, we should be discomforted because that's what will spur us on to action. So the strengthening of the hate crimes legislation that we know is moving is a really important and tangible step that we can take. But also knowing that our Department of Human Rights, I know Commissioner Lucero is on the phone, wants to be a partner, and we will certainly continue to lift up the work that is done there. But my community knows what it means to feel invisible and disposable at times. And so no one should have to feel that way. And I'm sorry that you're all experiencing this trauma and the re-traumatization over and over again. And so my heart breaks for you, but I am in this with you. And I know that the governor and first lady are as well. And Bo, I would just say to you, in your role with CAAL, I know that you are holding up the community while also trying to hold up yourself and your family simultaneously. That is what we do. And it is what we're called to do in these moments. But I want you to know that I see you and I'm grateful for that work. So Chimigwech, many thanks for the work that you do. And we are just so grateful to be your friends and partners and to stand with you in this moment.
Oh, you just got me all teary up. So thank you. I feel that and just feel so much for my community right now. So I apologize. I had said to folks that today was a very emotional day. So thank you for that. I know that Commissioner Lucero is here and she would like to say a few words.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Rebecca and I am the Commissioner for the Minnesota Department of Human Rights. I know many of you personally, and I wish we were together in person so that we could be embracing and holding one another. I hold it to be sacred being this space with all of you, and I want to thank you for having me here tonight. Like many of you, I'm feeling a range of emotions, heartbreak, exhaustion, rage, anxiety, all of it. At the end of the day, I deeply believe that we're interconnected and interdependent and we need each other. And so I'm so grateful to be in this space together. As a queer Chicana woman, your struggles are my struggles and our struggles together are against racism, misogyny, and oppression. So this evening, I wanna share two things with you. First, as the state civil rights enforcement agency, we remain committed to working every day to build a state where Asian Pacific Islander community members, Black, Latinx, Indigenous community members, everyone can thrive by enforcing civil rights laws. Everyone deserves dignity simply because we exist. And the second thing that I wanted to share with you is this number, 1-833-454-0148. I'll put it in the chat when I'm done talking to you, but that's the discrimination helpline. And I just continue to ask everyone to share that number and our website, mn.gov/mdhr. So we can continue to document and investigate incidents of illegal discrimination. And of course, continue to share information related to anti-API discrimination and bias with this group here today. In closing, this is something that I talk about a lot and it's been something I talk about a lot this past year. But I've spent in these moments that are really rough, I spend a lot of time listening to my ancestors and thinking about the many struggles that they went through, how my ancestors kept moving forward with hope and justice built into every single one of their actions. Some days I stand on my ancestors' shoulders and some days they hold me a bit tighter. Today is one of the days where they are holding me a bit tighter. I remember that we get to build the community we want together. That's what we're doing here today. We're building the community we want here together and we plant seeds for the future when we are the ancestors. Thank you so much for this time. And thank you for everything.
Thank you, Governor and the First Lady. Thank you, Lieutenant Governor and Commissioner Lucero for your time joining us tonight. We really appreciate your presence as leaders for our community and you know, I'm with Bo. How can you not get emotional? But we are really thankful for the community leaders who are tuning in tonight to join us in creating this space all together. I really want to kind of close it up here and have Yin introduce the monks from the Watai community to provide us a chanting. Thank you, everyone.
Yin, you're muted.
Okay, sorry. Sawasdee ka, Governor Tim Walz, First Lady, Lieutenant Governor Peggy, the community leader, friends and family. Thank you so much for having us. Right now, I'm at the temple. It's a Thai temple in St. Louis Park. We have four monks. We are really blessed to be part of St. Louis Park neighbor. And this space is a community space where everyone are all welcome. And every time I come here, I choose to be here for this meeting. So I feel like comfort and peaceful. And I'm glad at this time I get to be part of my second home here as well in a temple in Minnesota. So I'd like to introduce you to the monks. We have four monks here. Pra Mahajamnian Bunma the Abbot, Pra Ajahn Thirapat Tharapop Pongmala, Pra Ajahn Chan Chai Sila Am, and Pra Ajahn Thirajet Palasopsai. They are going to chant for everyone to bring a blessing and also chase away all the evil and the bad things, and that's true all of us. And may I please welcome Prachan Thirapat to introduce a little bit what is that chanting about. Thank you. Prachan, namaskar
ka. Okay, thank you. Hello, the Governor, First Lady, and everybody. Thank you for having us. We are chanting in the Pali language and so we're blessing for all of you and everybody. There's someone who got a bad thing in Minnesota, in Georgia, Atlanta, and we will chanting. This is a good luck. We will joy with a joy hand, joy heart, and joy head together. Next, we will chanting in Pali language. Please. Let's go. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhassa. Nato hitaya sapapaninam puretava paramesa papato sambodhimottamang etena satavacena hotrute chayamangkaram chayanto bodhiyamole sakyanam nantivatano evam tavam vichayo hojitaya susayamangkare aparajitapanam kese se patavipokare apise kesa papodhana akapato pamotatisunakatam sumangkaram supapatam suvotitam supano sumohoto chasuyetam brahmachari supatakinam kayakamam vachakamam patakinam patakinam manokamam panitite patakina patakina nikatavanarapantate patakine avatu sapamangharang rakantu sapatevata sapapotanupavena satasoti avatu te pavatu sapamangharang rakantu sapatevata sapatamanupavena satasoti avatu te pavatu sapamangkarang rakhatu sapatevata sapasanghano
ติภาวันตุเ
ต Thank you so much. Healing and be happy and healthy. Thank you for having us.
Thank you so much, Yen, and to our abbots from Wat Thai for being here and blessing us and also supporting us during this time. I now want to close this portion out with Sun Yun Shin, who is a healer, and you all might know her as a best-selling author and poet, but she is a gift in our community, and I want to give this time for her to close us out before we give a few moments of silence for the lost lives.
Thank you, Bo. Je irumun Shin San Young imida, yo giiso joso gomawo. Thank you for being here. I just have two parts to this. The first is, as a body worker, we are taught to always remember that our bodies are mostly water. And so as part of that healing tradition, which is really ancient and universal, invite you to sense into the reality that your body is 64% approximately water, that water is life, that we are on Dakota homeland and Ojibwe homelands, and that the water is life. It is our ancestor, our relative, and our future. And then I wanted to read a short poem to honor those we have just lost and all those that we have lost to, whose spirits we carry with us. Some of you may be familiar with the poet Teresa Hakyung Cha, who is very important to now two generations of Asian American women poets and Korean American women poets in particular, like myself. After a week after her novel Dictée came out in 1982, she was assaulted and murdered by a security guard in the Puck Building in New York City on November 5th, 1982. She was a Korean immigrant born on March 4th, 1951, and she spoke Korean, English, and French. And a wonderful Asian American poet named Jane Wong spent some time with her artistic archives and did some work a few years ago in conversation with the work of Teresa Hakyung Cha. So it's a 17-line poem, and just invite you to feel whatever you're feeling. The poem is called Our Barter by Jane Wong. If I ring a bowl of water, where will the sound go? What light will carry us across these shores? To wade, to wait upon, to wax and wane until we are wanted? What have we forgotten? Each morning, the starting out, the ant crawling out of the sink. We live here too. Wax melts away each word we say. Do you have the time it takes for a fire to be put out? Is there any country without fear? A cloud fills the screen, or is it smoke? The blind sees, the blind see, you say, aveugle voit. I am clearing a forest in order to see you better. What can you see? Yes, pomegranates. Voice, permutations, a cave, a curled mouth. For this, I give you this. Let us throw everything we know into the ocean. Let us listen to its churning, our curious grief. Kamsahamnida. Thank you.
Thank you, Siyoung, for closing us out. That was so beautiful. I also want to acknowledge that in the room we have Senator Fong He, as well as Council Member Nelsie Yang, and just wanted to acknowledge and thank you for joining us for this session. So I'm going to turn it over to Nick Kaur from our team to hold a moment of silence.